you!
Good God, Sophie. At this.
I thought tea out here would be nice. What is it?
It's young Oliver. Has an appointment in Harley Street. Isn't arriving till midnight. I ask you.
I'll get another chair.
Oh, yes, I'd do it if it wasn't for my leg. I mean, it's damned inconsiderate. Inconvenient. Meeting two trains, I ask you.
Really, Richard, what does it matter? I'm the one who copes with this annual invasion of your brothers and sisters' prattlings. Anyway, Calypso can meet him this year. She can drive now.
Not my car. Any cream?
No, dear, your nephews and nieces, but my car. Oliver's been wounded in Spain. I expect George and Sarah want to make sure he's all right.
George is a fool. Why did he allow the boy to get mixed up with these Dagos?
I expect Oliver asked. He just went. They're lucky he's come back. The Turnbull son has been killed.
At least he was fighting on the right side.
You mean right or right? As against left.
If you're going to start up again with that attitude, I refuse to discuss this scuffle in Spain. Where's that child Sophie? Just scarpered off again. Shouldn't she be here for tea? Sophie!
Coming! Coming, Uncle Richard!
Well, it's lovely.
How are you, Calypso?
Sophie, darling. Oh, hello, Aunt.
Where's your brother?
Oh, there you are, Walter.
Isn't this air wonderful after London? Hop in, Polly. How's Uncle Richard?
Yes, how's his leg? Did you hear about Oliver?
Oliver's coming on a late train. And nobody is to mention General Franco.
Oh, Aunt Helena, you spoiled sport.
Here, Sophie, sit on my knee.
Nice to see you.
Come and meet Ollie with me.
May I meet him, Aunt?
If you like, but Sophie should be in bed.
Just this once.
She's a grown child, she needs to sleep. She'll see Oliver tomorrow.
Mother spoke to Uncle Richard and he said Oliver had a near miss. And the bullet grazed the side of his head.
What do you think of the war, Aunt?
Which, what your uncle calls this scuffle in Spain, or the coming one?
The coming one. I shall join the Navy.
You were always sick, even in a dinghy.
Well, I shall get into submarines. We can't be sick underwater.
You're too young.
I'm 18, I've left school.
What about Oxford?
I haven't got a place. Not like Oliver.
Uncle George didn't at all like Oliver using his waiting year to go to Spain. He wanted him to learn German.
He wouldn't have liked Germany. I was there at Easter. It was vile. All those sea kyles and Jews verboten. Filthy brown shirt was rude to me in Munich because I was wearing shorts.
Let's not discuss politics or war. This may be our last summer holiday ever. Can't stop it anyhow.
Your uncle doesn't think there will be a war, so please don't discuss it with him. Here we are.
brown you are. You look like Suzanne Lenglen. Does it hurt? Does it hurt?
No, it doesn't. I can take the dressing off tomorrow. Are you driving?
Yes.
Where's the car?
Usual place.
Do you think there'll be a pub open?
Far too late. Have you taken to drink?
Just want to delay arriving.
Why?
All the questions.
There won't be many. Aunt Helena says we're not to talk about Spain or the war. How soon will it be, Oliver? How long have we got? They're all in bed at home.
Can we stop on the cliff before we get to the house?
Of course. Will this do? The terror run. Shall we do it this year? Polly says this may be our last holiday.
May I fuck you now? Now, at once. Calypso, I want to marry you. Well, can I?
I'm a virgin. I'd have a baby. Darling Oliver, I can't marry you. I want to marry somebody rich. You know that.
To keep you in the state to which you wish to be accustomed.
Yes. I do love you, Oliver. You know that. Besides, you're only 19. You have to go to Oxford.
Oxford? Christ.
Don't spoil our holiday.
All right, we'll have the terror run. Oh, God, I'm tired. The smell. Can't tell you what it's like.
What smell?
Death.
Bits of people, like Uncle Richard's missing leg. Imagine him hopping into bed with Helena.
Exactly, the poor sod. And we mock him.
You've changed.
No. Just woken up.
I'm sorry, Oliver.
Good night. Which room am I in?
The red room.
Thanks. Sophie, what are you doing here?
Aunt Helena wouldn't let me meet you. Calypso wanted to take me to the station.
Oh, she did?
She suggested it. But Aunt Helena said I must go to bed and see you in the morning. Are you cross?
No. You're cold. Come here. I'll warm you.
Let's warm each other. Ooh, get in with me.
Does your head hurt? Did you get shot?
No, it doesn't. You smell of soap. Did you feel lonely? I was.
Sometimes I do.
They're a funny lot. Polly and Walter have got each other. But you and I are onlys.
And Calypso.
Yes. And Calypso. Sophie, who was your father?
No one knows.
Mother must have.
But she died when I was born.
So, You've got Uncle Richard and Aunt Helena. Poor old Sophie.
I don't mind that.
Shh. Lie quiet. Perhaps we can hear the sea.
Oliver, you're crying.
Yes, I know. Just let me.
May we ask the Floyd twins over?
Of course. Telephone and ask them to lunch tomorrow. Such nice boys.
Extraordinary, considering their father's a conchie. I hear he's filled the rectory with Germans.
Actually, the Erstweilers are Austrian. He played the organ beautifully on Sunday, even though it needs repairing.
Playing for a supper. Well, as a Jew, I'm told.
Well, presumably that's why they're here.
Are there any young Erstweilers, Aunt?
One. He's in a camp.
Oh, hell. They must be worried stiff.
Raise him up. Do him good. General Peacham says they're splendid places. It's all talk and propaganda about the Jews.
What's propaganda? Forgive me coming down in a dressing gown, Aunt. Good morning, Uncle.
Concentration camps.
Oh, any kedgeree?
I ate it.
All of it?
There wasn't much, sorry.
That's all right. I'll eat an egg. I didn't think it worth dressing, as I intend to spend all day in the sun. Oliver's marvellously brown.
We're going to ask the rectory twins to lunch tomorrow.
If they're conscious like their father, I won't have them in my house.
It's Aunt Helena's house, Uncle. And Father says we should admire people like Mr. Floyer. If they'd been more like him in 1914, we'd all be living in a better world.
You want to stop it. He'll wreck the times if you tease him like that.
In any case, I shall be out tomorrow. Meeting the general at the golf club. I ask you.
Aunt Helena, he's worse than ever.
He doesn't want another war. Won't even admit it's coming. Here's Oliver. You're up early. That's not like you.
I'm developing new habits, Aunt. Not all of them good. Been swimming in the cove with the twins. Is there any coffee left for us?
Come in, twins. We were talking about you. We're going to ask you to lunch. Don't just stand there.
Hello.
Thanks.
Good morning.
Come and sit down, boys.
Thank you, we will.
Thanks, Mrs. Cuthbertson.
Uncle was suggesting you'll be conscious if there's a war.
No, Polly, not this war. One should fight for the Jews.
Two should.
Two will. Two are joining up at the end of the holidays.
Oh, what in?
Air Force.
Long distance killing. Heard of Guernica?
Of course we have.
Picasso.
I shall join the Navy just as soon as I can.
Don't stop it, children. There may not be a war. It may not happen. All that over again.
I can't.
Oh, say.
Poor Aunt Helena.
Uncle Richard's her second. She lost her first husband in the last war.
We'll not face the fact that in all of us, even her, there's a person who is capable of killing. In you, and you, and...
What difference does it make? There's going to be a war.
Wait for me.
Helena, where are you?
Here.
I don't often interfere in your department, but this time I must insist.
What?
That child, Sophie, is wearing no knickers.
How on earth do you know?
I saw Oliver pick her up.
Oh, is that all?
All? It's indecent. Ask you.
Richard, she's only 10. She never wears knickers if it's hot. Nor do I, if it comes to that. They're a Victorian invention. Your friend the General wants you to telephone. He's going to put the hounds down. He thought you ought to know, as you're on the committee.
Good God. So he thinks there will be a war?
Yes, my dear, he does.
Helena. Helena, I'm useless.
Nonsense, Richard. There'll be masses of things for you to do. ARP, things like that.
Answering the telephone, I ask you. I've only one leg.
You don't answer the telephone with your legs. Now, I must get on if Cook and I are to feed your army of relations.
What about Sophie's knickers?
There's going to be a war. What the hell do Sophie's knickers matter?
When's the full moon?
Thinking of the terror run?
Shall we let Sophie do it? She wants to.
Why not? She practices first.
Will you tell her? Fill her cup of happiness.
A moment ago, I was on the Ebro. One of my friends was killed. Never made a sound. Shot through the jugular. He and his friends burned a priest. Made a bonfire and burnt him. Joke was, turned out he was one of us. Or had been.
Joke?
Atrocities are jokes. Can't survive otherwise. We all committed them, on both sides.
You did?
I stood by. Comes to the same thing. We're all drunk. There's an awful lot of waiting about. Fill the time, you burn, rape, pillage.
Rape?
Well, actually, she was more than willing. And I thought, oh, God, I may get clapped. Luckily, I didn't.
Just the once?
No, sweet. Every time I got the chance.
So that's why you say we're all capable of killing. Look how far out the twins are. They've got Sophie with them.
They won't drown her.
Do you know, Ollie? Their father was a stretcher bearer in the war.
Jolly brave. Never talked about him. He's not a war bore. Sophie, want to join the terror run? Come on out!
What did you say?
Want to join the terror run this year?
Yes, please!
You'll have to practice.
I know the path. I know it better than any of you, only... There's that bit by the Coast Guard's hut.
It's safe there.
Yes, I know. Will you watch the whole way?
Yes, we'll watch both ends and the middle, and we'll see how you do.
Oh, thanks, Oliver.
See what it is to give happiness.
Will you run?
Of course. You bet. When is it?
Full moon, whenever that is.
When I do the practice run soon, will you watch?
Of course. How about this afternoon? How'll that be?
My nose getting red.
Put a leaf on it.
Clever. Find me one.
Ready, steady, go!
Go on, Sophie!
Go on, Soaps!
She's off. Walter's unleashed her. I wonder how the world will look from the air. Never flow.
Do you think they'll keep us together?
You think they'd separate us?
Mayhap. My God, I hope not.
Death could. Not us.
Sophie's going lickety split.
Be around the headlands too. Calypso and Oliver will see her in.
Thank you. what, Ollie? Even if I won't marry you, I'll sleep with you. Have you ever done it?
Yes.
Is it nice?
Nice? Nice? I want to have you to myself. I'll wait.
If there's a war, I'll sleep with you before you get killed.
That's what maidens do in books, and I'm a maiden.
How you do carry on about your virginity. Virginity's nothing. You can lose it riding a bicycle.
I never knew that. I must be careful. I'm going to get a bicycle in London. Pa says petrol will be rationed.
And virginity not. How are you going to find your rich prince on a bicycle? It's so bourgeois.
If you want something hard enough, you get it. And I want a rich husband very much.
Calypso, don't. My love, my darling, I'll get rich. Completely filthy, bloody awful, stinking rich.
What's that? Somebody screamed. Sophie!
Something's wrong.
Sophie! 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 Sophie, what is it? What happened?
Are you hurt?
What's the matter?
Did it bite you?
No. No. I'm all right. Sorry. Did I run fast?
Must have been a record.
I'll be even quicker by moonlight. You'll see.
What's up?
Not going to tell us.
So peaceful. In our country at harvest time a year ago, we were full of fear.
We are still, but not for ourselves.
It is worse to be safe and apparently not. Surely God will help us.
God with us! Don't be ridiculous.
Father says we mustn't lose faith in God, but we have already. We lost it when we slipped our cartilages at Rugger.
Both the same?
We lost the match as well. We really had prayed.
How old were you?
12.
And you topped him, just like that?
We never told Father.
Your father is a saint. I say this in case there are saints. Though personally, I doubt it.
You go to Father's church. You play the organ for
it's
him.
It's the least I can do for your father and mother. Also, you boys are fortunate.
We are. It'll be all right, Monica. You wait and see. We'll fight for you. We're going to join the Air Force. And get your son out of camp.
In a casket. You know, they send you a casket. Our son is a musician. You cannot play the piano in a casket.
And what is this game you play tonight?
We race along the cliff path. Oliver called it the Terror Run because he's afraid of heights. It's a bit scary in places, but even Sophie can do it now. We run by the light of the moon.
Have you watch?
Of course. The elders sit on the Camomile Lawn and gossip while they time us.
Hello! Isn't this terrific? We persuaded her to let us dine on the lawn.
No, it's all you can.
Isn't this fun? Come on.
That's a brilliant idea.
Uncle Richard, this is Monica Espider and Max Espider. They're staying at the rectory.
Saw you in church, I believe. You know my wife, Helena?
So glad you could come. That was the first time I spoke to him.
Sorry?
Max, on the Camomile Lawn, it has a special scent. I planted it just before the war.
Oh. He wasn't famous then, was he?
He was a refugee from Nazi Germany. The general said...
The general?
General Peacham, our neighbour.
Oh.
Loathed Jews, admired Hitler. master of hounds, a typical country gentleman, a good man. They do a lot of harm. My dear boy, must you drive quite so fast? I'd far rather be late for this funeral than early for my own.
Sorry, great aunt.
This is the party we have every year. It may be the last.
Every year, out of doors?
No, never before. But tonight it seems safe. And it's fun for the children.
They talk of fighting. Are they not men?
I suppose they are. Men.
Drinks! You have a son in camp, I believe. My friend the General says they're doing your people a power of good. When they're hurt.
Come on, everyone. We'll start dinner as soon as the sun sets. Drinks time!
The moon!
Wait, wait. Another toast. To absent friends.
Absent friends.
Thank you.
Now for the terror run. Bags, I go first.
Me next. Will you time us, Uncle Richard?
Got your torch?
Yes.
Same rules, I take it. Flash the torch when you start.
Yes.
Off you go, then.
Come on, twins.
Isn't Sophie rather young?
She's running with the twins.
She'll be all right.
I can see no path. It must be dangerous.
They all know it very well. If I had my leg, I'd think nothing of it.
And where's the finish?
Below us, out of sight. They shout when they reach it. I time them, and my word is final.
Look, Oliver's starting.
Oliver! Calypso! Twins! Sophie! Polly! Walter!
Come on, Sophie, run! Faster!
Next.
Sophie and the twins. Holly and Walter last. Oliver, what's that?
Me. My cock.
Oliver.
What's wrong?
It's enormous.
It's quite ordinary. I've got an erection. I want to poke it into you. Have you never seen a man with an erection?
No.
So you really are intacta. A virgin. I didn't believe you.
Wouldn't it hurt?
No. Think how you got to stretch to let a baby out. You know how babies are born, don't you?
Of course I do.
I love you. I always shall.
I don't think you will.
Come on, Sophie! Run faster! Come on, run! Faster, faster, come on!
Well
done!
Sophie, home!
David here! Paul here! Ah,
Polly here!
Walter here!
Uh,
God, I'm all in. Never again.
Very probable. This time next year, where shall we all be?
Under the sod.
You'll be under the sea, in your submarine.
So I shall.
Uncle Richard wants a dog.
How do you know?
He's missing old Farticus.
Helena won't be pleased. It's time we stopped always considering Aunt Helena. She gave him a pretty nasty look just before dinner.
Well, he deserved it, talking about the general.
Down with all generals, especially Franco.
What are you going to do, Calypso, if there's a war? Find a glamorous job with lots of rich men.
I really think she means it. Won't you comfort the truth?
I shall do that too. Impartially. Well, did Oliver win as usual?
It was your father on the telephone. He says his hospital is going to be evacuated from London.
War.
We should be going.
Yes. Yes, we must thank you. Thank you both. It was charming.
Full moon, weather set fair.
We should get through to Mother.
Yes, use the telephone. And Sophie, you should go to bed. It's long past your bedtime.
Richard?
Yes, my dear. Good party. Thank you for your trouble.
It was no trouble.
Sorry I dropped a brick with those Jews.
Well, you made up for it. Richard. I don't think I can sleep yet. Can we talk?
What about?
The war.
It's another false alarm. There isn't going to be a war.
The hospitals and doctors are being evacuated. The children, too. Martin has been...
Just another bloody exercise. The general says...
The general is killing the hounds.
He hasn't done it yet. Good God, Helena, there won't be a war. I won't be a party to this panicking and women's gossip.
I can't talk to you.
What do you mean?
I can't. If you deny what is happening, how can I talk to you? All those children will be in it. All the horrors will happen again. Only worse... I can't stand it. I can't stand your head in the sand attitude anymore. I'm going to London.
London? What on earth for?
Oh, what do you think? To do some shopping!
War changes everything.
Does it?
Of course it does. Now, will you marry me? I must have you if I'm to fight.
You could get a safe job.
I'm committed.
Who to?
Myself. You.
I'm not asking you to fight. I didn't ask you to rush off to Spain in that silly way.
Against fascism. The Nazis.
Some of them are awfully nice. Well, that lot I met skiing. I loved that lot in Kisbuel.
Calypso, look at me. I'm serious. At least let's get engaged.
No. It's 100 times. I will comfort you, as they say. But marriage, no. I'd only make you unhappy.
I'd risk that. I'm unhappy already.
Well, then, you've a taste of what I'd be like. Gosh, I'm sleepy. Good night, Ollie.
I'll hold you to the comfort bit.
You do that.
Sophie, you were listening.
Yes.
You shouldn't do that.
I happen to be here. I often am.
Come down. I'll catch you.
There you are. There.
Thanks. It's high tide.
War tide.
I'm frightened. Are you?
Yes. Very.
Worse than the terror run?
Much. This is real.
I'll run again in your honour.
Funny little thing. You should be in bed.
Let me stay a bit.
I'm leaving, Sophie.
When?
Now. The sooner the better. There's nothing for me here.
I'd comfort you. Will you come back? Promise.
Perhaps.
You all right?
Yes, I've run out of petrol.
I can walk on ahead and get you some. The garages will be open by the time I get there.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's only a mile or two.
You can leave your pack.
Yes. Where are you going?
London.
Me too.
I can drive you there. We can take turns.
Are you staying with Mother?
I hadn't thought.
She'd be glad to put you up.
We can have breakfast at Truro and telephone her there.
Good idea.
Breakfast at the Red Lion. If we're still there, then. Bodmin Moor, Ilminster, Ilchester. It was the old A30-303 in those days.
When?
When I drove up to London with Oliver, 40 years ago, more.
Oliver Anstey? I've read his novels, some of them. He was quite well known.
He's still alive, very much so.
There was one about the Civil War in Spain. Always seemed to be looking for something, doesn't know what it is.
You're very perceptive.
So great-aunt Sarah would have been his mother.
Yes, she would. She was.
Sarah! Hello! You must be exhausted. I'm coming down.
Sarah, I had to come up. Oh. I hope you don't mind. I can go to an hotel.
Don't be absurd! George will be in soon. They've hustled him into the Admiralty. He's terribly busy, overworked already. Darling, how's your poor head?
I can't make up my mind in Cornwall. I never can.
No, of course not. I understand.
Sarah, I'm thinking of leaving Richard.
Yes, I thought as much. Why did you marry him? We've always wondered.
I don't really know. Could it have been because he had known Anthony before he was killed? Because I needed someone to look after? Or pity, because he was lumbered with orphan Sophie? It wasn't love.
Not love, of course. I'm so unused to cooking, but George insisted on a real Sunday lunch. Do you think it's doing all right?
I expect so. He had a fine war record. Of course, that seemed to matter. I wish he wouldn't limp so obviously. Shall I do the greens? I know how.
Yes, please. Be an angel. Here's a knife.
I've suddenly realised why I married Richard.
Why?
His leg. It was his leg.
Oh, well, that's a good reason. Much better than if it was his leg.
Oh, dear, isn't it awful how one says those things?
What were you going to say?
Well, I was going to say that was much better than if his leg had come between you. And, of course, it can't.
No, poor dear. He always takes it off before we go to bed.
You two down there.
You've missed the announcement.
Chamberlain on the wireless. It's happened.
We're at war.
Bother, I meant to listen to that jackass.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
I thought you didn't believe in him anymore.
No. If I really did, I wouldn't say it.
Air raid.
Get in quick. Take cover. Get your gas masks and take cover. Air raid. Air raid.
A sausage. Can't see a thing.
Loosen your tie, darling. You'll choke.
Anything? Any plagues?
Not a thing.
These boys, the Floyer twins from the rectory.
You want to take cover, driver?
No. Bank shoulder shine.
Thanks.
Slip in, Oliver. Where's Walter?
Got off the train at Plymouth to join the Navy. Gosh, what a gorgeous smell of beef.
Oh my God, the joint.
It's all right.
A bit overcooked, I think.
Delicious.
Suppose this is the time to make my announcement. Join the army.
When?
I've got a commission.
In the ranks. But I think having been in the OTC helped a bit. Actually, I fixed it up before I went down to Cornwall.
What about Spain?
They didn't ask, so I didn't tell them.
We'd better buck up. I wonder where we go.
Air Force? Try the Air Ministry.
I expect there'll be posters. Our country needs us.
Where are you all staying in town?
With me. Mother and father have gone to Godalming, where his hospital's been evacuated. They said Calypso could stay, and the twins till they're fixed up.
What are you girls going to do now there's a war?
Any ideas, Uncle George?
Well, I can give you some introductions, I suppose.
Actually, I've got a job. Fixed myself up months ago.
That was clever. Lucky you.
Is it glamorous? I hardly think so. Just war office.
Helena, are you all right up there? When are you coming home?
Well, not at once. I've got some shopping. All kinds of things. There'll be shortages. I'm going to stock up.
It's very inconvenient without the car.
Well, ask the general to drive you.
Helena. Helena, he put the hounds down. Can you believe? I ask you. You may be right about Hitler. The general thinks so too. I mean, only a rancor could behave like that.
Poor Richard. The hounds.
Are you going back?
Not yet. I have to think.
What about Sophie?
Sophie is what a lot of it's about. It's not altogether the leg. It's Sophie too. Sarah, I don't like Sophie.
Richard's half-sister's little accident. It was noble enough of you to take her on. Why don't you send her to school? I mean, a proper boarding school.
In wartime?
Helena, life's not stopping. It's going on, war or not. Find the child a school. Send her away. You'll both be much happier.
Do you think so?
Ask Polly. She was quite happy at her school. Calypso's wouldn't do. She was expelled, flirting with the gardener.
But Polly's was near Cambridge.
There are such things as trains. Ask Polly and check with her mother. Make a list. Start with leg, then Sophie, then your shopping. You can cross out leg straight away as there's nothing you can do about it.
You're rushing me.
There is a rush. Being hated at Sophie's age isn't right.
I never said I hated her.
Not being liked. It comes to the same thing.
I knew you'd help. Wants their daughter with them.
Helena, Richard telephoned. He wants you to ring him back.
Why?
It's Sophie.
What's happened?
He won't or can't say. He sounds rather desperate.
He must have told you.
Helena, you know what he's like, and he was more than usually impossible.
But I've actually been to Harrods to buy a puppy. I've sent it down to him. All right. I'll go.
Ah, there you are. Heard you coming.
Where's Sophie?
Got your present. Choose everything. It's eaten my best cardigan.
Where is Sophie?
In bed at the rectory.
Why? What's happened?
Won't say. The rectory offered. Seemed better for her to be with a woman. I can't do much with my leg. Monica Erstweiler sits with her. The doctor said to keep her quiet.
But what happened, for God's sake?
That's what she doesn't say.
You better come too.
Where are you going?
To the rectory, of course.
The rector found her on the cliff road. Thought she looked odd. Offered her a lift. He passed out in his car. Hasn't spoken since. Just lies there.
Any signs? I mean, has he...
Not interfered with. Nothing. Where she was, can't have seen anything of Penrose either.
Penrose?
Coast Guard chap. You know him. The army's wiring off the path, I ask you. Hitler's not going to invade up perpendicular cliffs.
What about Penrose?
Fell over. Drunk, I suppose, or suicide. Moody fellow, his wife says. Anyway, the army found him. Gives the police something to do. I had my leg.
Damn your leg! What happened to Sophie?